Hi, welcome to this week's edition of the SHTICK. We have Manny Waks with us to talk about a very interesting and topical subject. Hi, Manny.
Hi, Henry. Thank you for having me.
It's okay. You've got a background at the Yeshiva College. You went right through school there, literally?
Yes, in the mid-80s, I commenced schooling at the Yeshiva College in East St Kilda when I was about 9 years old. And during that time, unfortunately, as it turns out, like others, I had been sexually abused by two separate perpetrators within the Yeshiva community, not necessarily teachers, but people within the Yeshiva community.
So the issue of child sex abuse has suddenly come into the open, although we know that it's been in the media now through watching Compass and several other shows, that since 1992 there have been people coming out and nothing's been done about it.
It's all, I guess, depending on your perspective of nothing has been done about it. Obviously, there have been some things happening behind the scenes individually. Some of these individual victims trying to take action, whether it's through the courts or seeking psychological help or whatever. But now it's become obviously a major topical issue for the community in that there have been a number of announcements about inquiries in Victorian government has launched one, in New South Wales they launched one, and ultimately a few months ago there was the Royal Commission announced by the Australian government as well, which is certainly a welcome development.
Certainly is. And the background that you have is through ultra-Orthodox schooling, which you would have imagined would have been a safe place at that time. You couldn't have imagined that that sort of thing would have occurred.
Absolutely. Henry, I grew up in a Chabad, ultra-Orthodox environment. Chabad is a Hasidic sect within the ultra-Orthodox movement. And certainly the issue of sex, full stop, is never discussed, let alone the issue of child sexual abuse. So certainly that's not something that I had anticipated or expected, and when it did ultimately happen to me, certainly had no idea what was happening to me.
And you kept it suppressed. You didn't really come out about it until 1996 when you came back from the Israeli army for your sister's wedding. Is that right?
Yeah, more or less. When I was, during the abuse, with the first perpetrator at the age of 12, 11, 12, is when I actually did share it with a friend of mine. Ultimately, that friend betrayed me and shared it with a few other friends, and then it became well known within the Yeshiva school, some of my classmates and others. But in terms of speaking directly to adults about it, I did raise that, what happened to me when I was 20 years old, when I came back from Israel. I'd served in the army and I came for a brief visit to come to for my sister's wedding in 96. And then I happened to hear on the radio there was a police operation targeting child sexual abuse. And as soon as I heard that, I went to my father's office and I told him that I had something to share with him. And that's when the first time I told him about it. And I asked him if he can call the police about it, and he did. And then detectives came over and I gave them a full statement, and sure along things started developing from there.
But nothing has really happened since then. From that time on, it's only been in the last few months that it's really come out in the open. So from 1996 till now, that's a full 17 years. What happened in the interim?
Sure, that's a very valid question. Firstly, before 96, this was something obviously that I'd been carrying with me for many years internally and not sharing it with anyone, and obviously feeling very angry and upset about it. Very common for victims of such abuse to actually feel a range of emotions, guilt, shame, among others, anger. But ultimately, after 96, when I did share this with the police and I made a statement, at the time they spoke to one of the perpetrators in my case. The other one was overseas at the time. Of course, he denied everything. And for some reason, the police felt that there was not much more they could do. They said to me that they weren't going to close the file, so they left it open until more evidence comes to light. Ultimately, I felt that nothing else can be done about it, because obviously I shared it with the police. A few years later, I also, and around that time as well, I shared this information with Rabbi Groner, who's the person in charge of the Yeshiva Center, not just the Yeshiva College, which is the school, but Yeshiva Center is kind of the broader body encompassing the school, the synagogue, and other of the yeshiva entities.
And it's a boys' school because there's also the Beth Rivka College, which is, so you had segregated because it's such an Orthodox religious organization. There was a girls' school and then there was a boys' school.
Absolutely.
And did you know of any other boys at that time who had experienced abuse?
Yes, I did know for a fact of at least one other person who had experienced abuse by the same perpetrator in my case. Mm-hmm. And then, so as I was saying, that nothing had happened between 96 after I spoke to the police and I spoke to Rabbi Groner. From my perspective, I had done everything that I could to try to address the abuse I suffered. Nothing happened, so I kind of almost raised my hands in despair. But then all of a sudden, around a year and a half ago in July 2011, I decided, after carefully considering it, going public, and I shared my story with The Age, and ultimately we are where we are today. About a year and a half later, there are about three court cases at the moment taking place within the Jewish community. Not all of them, two of them are within the yeshiva community, and this issue now is getting the coverage and the it's being discussed at the level that it needs to be discussed and addressed.
Before this 18-month period, all the media and all the attention was really placed in the Catholic and the Christian brothers and in the Catholic Church, where there was a lot of controversy. And as I mentioned, Compass Program and Four Corners did at least 10 programs on this particular issue. And nothing was ever done until the policeman, Detective Sergeant Fox, spoke about it, and that instigated the commission. And so it's been interesting that so many years have gone by and it's been swept under the carpet.
Certainly. I mean, as someone who had experienced what I experienced, it was very frustrating to constantly hear the experiences within the Catholic Church, and knowing full well of what has been going on within the Jewish community and the ultra-Orthodox community in particular. So it was very frustrating to feel that we're being ignored. But ultimately what I felt is the right thing to do is to make sure that people know about the abuse that we suffered, to make everyone aware that this is not just a Catholic Church issue. Mm. This is also within
much
our
broader
own backyard. So that's why I felt it was imperative for me, as someone who has held leadership positions within the Jewish community, including at that time, senior leadership positions, if I wasn't going to get up and take a strong action to address this issue, then no one else would. So I felt compelled to take this.
Mm. We'll be back after the break with more of Manny Waks speaking about this very, very interesting topic.